Hello everyone, this is Rahul KP, Student Placement Coordinator from Computer Science Branch from National Institute of Engineering. Today, I'll be discussing about probability. So what is probability? Probability is a possibility that determines the occurrence of an event. Now, let's take some example. Some of the experiments carried out are like tossing a coin or throwing a dice or playing with cards. Now, let's see how probability is represented. So probability can be represented as favorable outcome divided by total number of outcomes. I repeat, probability can be represented as favorable outcome divided by total number of outcomes. Now let us take a simple example to this. So the example I'll be taking is tossing of a coin. So tossing a coin has two outcomes. That is either head or tail. Now, let's calculate the probability of head. Since there are two outcomes, the total number of outcome is 2, that is the denominator is 2 and the numerator is 1. So, the probability of getting head is 1 by 2, that is 0.5. Similarly, probability of getting tail is 0.5. Now, I'll be telling some tips and tricks to solve the probability problems. First one, whenever you encounter an AND in a question, you need to multiply. That is, for example, calculate the probability of a king and a queen. Then you need to multiply the probabilities. Second one, so if you see an OR in the question, you need to add. And the third one, at least. If you find the word at least, you need to calculate the value from minimum to maximum. For example, minimum. So at least if calculate the probability of getting at least two red balls from a bag, then the minimum value will be 2 and the maximum value will be the maximum capacity of the bag. The last word is at most. At most values is from maximum to minimum. Now let's discuss about some problems related to probability. The first case is coin problem. So when you toss a coin, there are only two outcomes. That is, tossing one coin, you will get either head or tail. Tossing two coins, you have four outcomes. That is 2n outcomes. Tossing 3 coins, you have 8 outcomes, that is 2n, that is 8 outcomes. Now let's take a simple example. The first question is, if 2 coins are tossed simultaneously, find the probability of getting tails. Now let's write the formula, probability equal to favorable outcome by total number of outcomes. In the question, they have asked us to find the probability of getting two tails. And when you toss two coins simultaneously, the outcomes are, you'll be getting two heads simultaneously, one tail or one head or one tail or both tails. So getting two tails, there are only one possibility of getting two tails. So the probability is 1 divided by total number of outcome is 4. So 1 by 4. Let us move on to the next question. The question says, 3 coins are tossed, find the probability of getting at least 2 heads. You have to find the probability of at least 2 heads by throwing 3 coins simultaneously. So as I have written here, the outcomes of tossing the 3 coins, we will get 8 outcomes and the outcomes are 3 heads, 3 tails, 2 heads, 1 tail, like that. So they have asked us at least 2 heads. So at least 2 heads means, we have to calculate from minimum to maximum value. So the minimum value here is 2 and the maximum value is 3. So the possibility are 3 heads, 2 heads, 2 heads, 2 heads. Yeah, there are 4 outcomes. The probabilities should contain at least 2 heads or 3 heads. So the probability having outcomes having one head is not considered in this problem. So there are four outcomes, and the total number of outcomes is 8 here. So that is equal to 1 by 2. Now let's move on to the next question. The next variety is dice problems. So when you roll a dice, when you roll a single die, there are 6 outcomes. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the faces of the cube. So when you roll 2 dice, the outcomes are 6 power 2, that is 36 outcomes. So we'll solve a problem related to this. The first question is, in a single throw of 2 dice, what is the probability of getting a doublet? The question given here is a doublet. A doublet meaning both sides should have same number. Same number in the sense 1, 1. So there are 6 outcomes here. That is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, and 6, 6. So finding the probability of getting the doublet is favorable outcome divided by total number of outcome. So the favorable outcome here is 6 outcomes divided by 36, that is equal to 1 by 6. The next type of problem is card problems. Totally there are 4 types, that is a diamond, heart, club and spade. Diamond and heart are in red in color, club and spade are in black color. So each shape has 13 cards in total. Totally there are 52 cards in a deck. There are 4 kings, 4 queens, 4 jacks, 4 aces, and also face cards are present. Now let us see a question about this. The first question is, one card is drawn at random from the well shuffled pack of 52 cards. What is the probability of picking an ace of spades or jack of diamonds? Solution. So they have given us to find the probability of picking ace of spades or jack of diamonds. So spade has 13 cards and whereas diamond has 13 cards. So the probability is favorable outcome divided by total number of outcome. So getting one card from each, that is 1 plus 1. Since the question says spades or jack, we need to add the probabilities, that is 1 plus 1 divided by total number of outcome is 52 here. So the probability is 2 by 52, that is equal to 1 divided by 26. Thank you.